most beautiful beaches between Cabarete and Samaná. Mucho turistas aquí. Okay, this is the town of Samaná. This is the bay. This is the local docking facility, the only one in one of the most beautiful bays in the Caribbean. And there's the boys on their motorcycles. We're doing a little easy rider trip here today. And we're going across the street. This is the town itself. Beautiful little plaza. Tour buses coming on a daily basis. And the hotel. It's an easy rider himself, Duncan. This is Fred. He's a developer from West Palm.
Evidence? Is this evidence for the trial?
Yep, this is it. We're gonna get everything you do crazy on film.
Okay.
All right.
Get a nightlight for that then.
Yeah, we will. We will. Well, this is Samaná Country Estates. This is about 200 acres that we've divided into 5-acre parcels. As you can see, we're right on the ocean. And this is Samaná Country Estates, as far as the eye can see.
Gorgeous. Great day for photographs.
A gazebo, they call it.
Yeah, well, I'm building one here, 14 feet square, here. Stone floor, column. Duncan originally had 8,000 feet on the boat. 8,000 feet. That's all right. That up?
This is Las Galeras. Around that point is Rincon. This is a great place to set up a hammock and just hang loose
folks at home.
Say hello to Los Estados Unidos. Hola.
Don't send me there. Like monkey.
Oh. That's a flying coconut.
He's our coconut cutter, our road builder, our watcher. He's our all-around good guy. Takes
general
care of everybody.
Let's introduce Mr. Shepherd, our general contractor here.
This is our builder. He's of English ancestry.
Yes, an English builder.
His great-grandfather came from England. He worked for King Richard.
I came to work here.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I've had a Charles Cabral company.
Muy importante, hombre. Muy importante.
Yeah. That's a very
interesting thing. Well, this is my father's Uncle Bill's house. As you can see, the roof is made out of solid concrete. The reason why that's done is because wood is very expensive here. The government doesn't allow any forestation, which is a good thing. And the second reason is because there's no fire department. The third reason, hurricane proof. Very, very solid construction. The building costs here are about a third of what they are in Florida. Workers have their own little kitchen set up. They take a 2-hour siesta every day. This is Las Galeras. Around that point is great. These are some of the local fishermen. That's where that box that they're putting in the boat is where they keep their ice. They'll go out for 2 days at a time, sleep on the boat, and just keep fishing until they fill up that box. This is a French-owned restaurant right on the beach. What do you think, Duncan?
Beautiful.
This is paradise.
Oh. This is gorgeous. Evidence.
Very beautiful. I think I could hang out here for a while.
A couple of years.
So how was your vacation?
Fantastico. This is, I guess, about the sixth time that I've been here.
Usually we take a little boat around the point to our property, Rincon. But I think we're going to skip that this trip and then we'll go to Las Galeras tomorrow. But this is a fantastic place. A lot of Europeans come here for the season. The gals go topless if they want to, no problem. Sand on the beach here, I don't know if you can see it, but this is some of the finest, purest sand that I've ever seen in my life. There's lots of boats that you can get, take for little trips here and there. But I think we're going to get on the bikes right now, and we're going to do a little exploring, see some things that I haven't seen before. If you pan over this way, they have all sorts of little huts with locally cooked and prepared foods, cooked on the open grill. That's the French restaurant. There's some tourists. Not too many coconut trees.
Here's one of our local chefs here, refreshing herself with El Coco.
What were they offering here?
Here they have fish, lobster, all sorts of good things at very reasonable prices.
And the kitchen, and there's a shot of the kitchen?
Yeah, this is a shot of the kitchen. They, it's pretty primitive, but the food is absolutely delicious. And the prices are unbelievable. This place is packed with people during the season. This is the off season now. But as you can see, it develops a pretty lively atmosphere, music right on the beach, lots of rum, good food, rice, chicken, anything you want. They got a
lobster out there on that reef. I gotta get out there one day.
Tranquila?
Tequila?
Tranquila. Tequila.
Duncan?
You want tequila or tranquila?
Muy tranquilo.
A little bit of tequila with some tranquila.
Yes. They both come together.
Yeah.
Right. Take a ride down there.
We'll take a ride.
Thank you.
There he is.
There he is. These guys are fishing out here.
Yeah.
For what? Anything that comes in.
Yeah, anything they catch. They're fishing with nets. No motors, nothing. Totally natural.
Los Haitistas, well, I guess on that end, close to the elbow over here. Well, that's someone else's property over there.
What is all, what are all those little boats over there and those
things to lay out on those benches? Is that a hotel?
There's a little French restaurant over there, a very small restaurant.
Yeah.
This is the back of the Grand Bahia Hotel. And we're heading out to an island just outside.
I put that on tape already, so they saw that.
About a mile offshore.
Satellite disc. Get all the American channels on TV, no problem.
Except yeah, but up there on top of the hill is a private cottage, six rooms that can be rented.
Oh yeah,
by a group of people.
How much?
Oh, look at that.
I'm not sure. I think 10,000 pesos a day.
Oh, that's nice. You have a big party up there.
Oh yeah. The swimming pool up there, your own swimming pool. See, the tournament
was there about 3 months ago.
Oh yeah.
This is a captain of our ship here.
We've been in this before.
Wait.
All right, turn it off. That's
wait.
Enough.
That's
France wanted five countries.
No, we're at Samana now. Six.
Of course, we always have to have a pretty
yesterday.
Girl. That's Britannia.
Yes.
When
we get back, we'll have
hold that lobster up. Yeah, they're a little bit on the small side here.
Boy, that's a nice sized lobster.
What do you think, Danny? They just swim out on the reef and pick those up and serve them right up, fresh as can be.
They're big enough you can eat the legs on these puppies.
Yeah. All right.
This is what Bella's going to be sleeping with tonight.
Awful spiny.
Right? Und in vier der Frauen noch da, ne? Weil die sind schon fertig. Ja? Langsam werden wir eh einbringen. Wenn er direkt geht, dann kann man sich mal.
this is the east side of...
I-11 Tonto, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's recording beautifully.
Just pan to the right.
That is the Gran Bahia across the channel. We're probably about 75 feet above sea level here. Looking towards the east side of the peninsula.
What's the name of this island?
Cayo La Ventado. And now we're looking east. Puerto Rico is about 100 miles that way.
Cuidado.
I can't believe you can do that.
They have an erosion problem here. Marine architect was hired by the government to do a study. They'll probably have to shore it up somehow.